today I'm going to talk about my favourite stick and ferment flavours, and I'm going to give you the recipe on how much to use and the quantities and how many days to ferment it. I have quite a few favourite stick and ferment recipes, but you can ferment with whatever you want, fruit or veggies, and get any colour, taste that you'd like. And depending on how many days you leave it and how sugary the fruit and vegetables is, how fizzy that you can make it. One of my favourite flavours is apple pie, and this is how you make it. One small green or red apple, but I prefer to use green apple. Half a teaspoon of cinnamon and half a teaspoon of spice mix. Or you could do half a teaspoon of cinnamon and half a teaspoon of chai spice tea mix to 4 to 5 cups of kombucha. And then leave to ferment for 3 days. And take out the apple and the spice, bottle it up again, and let it ferment for as much as you like. Or you could drink it that day. Doesn't matter. My second one is fruity kombucha mix. This makes quite a large quantity, but you can make it quite a small quantity. It does 20 to 24 cups of kombucha, and you only leave it overnight. So you need half a cup of strawberries, half a cup of raspberries, one lime, and 20 mint leaves, and then you leave it to ferment overnight, and it flavours it really good overnight if you want to make something for a party the next day, or you could just add the fruit to it during the day and just serve it in one of those massive coolers. And with wine glasses. Another one of my favourite flavours is Love Potion, and that is a third of a cup of strawberries, half a lime, 10 mint leaves, and 4 to 5 cups of kombucha. And you can leave that anywhere from 1 to 3 days, and then you take out the fruit, and then you can leave it for as much time or as little time as you want. It'll just keep getting more fizzy. And my other favourite flavour is Ras Passion, half a cup of raspberry or strawberry, 2 teaspoons of rose petals, the edible ones, and 4 to 5 cups of kombucha. And you could add mint to that or lime. I'm really good at using mint and lime in my second ferment. And lemon and lime, so that is just 4 to 5 cups of kombucha to half a lemon and half a lime. And you could add ginger to it, and that makes it extra fizzy and really nice. Another one I like is pina colada, 1/3 cup of pineapple, half a lime, 10 mint leaves, to 4 to 5 cups of kombucha. Leave that anywhere from 1 to 3 days, and you take out the fruit. And you can leave it ferment for as much or as little time as you like. Lemon, lime and mint is really good. Half a lemon, half a lime, 10 mint leaves, and 4 to 5 cups of kombucha. And also leave that for 10 days. Just plain ginger is good, so you could have 4 to 5 cups of kombucha to a thumb of ginger. It turns out like ginger beer. And mango with a kick is a good one. Half a cup of mango and a pinch of cayenne pepper to 4 to 5 cups of kombucha, and leave for 1 to 3 days again, and then take the fruit out. Apple and pomegranate is a really good flavour. One red apple to a third of a pomegranate to 4 to 5 cups of kombucha, and leave it 1 to 3 days. With the second ferment, I suggest that you take out the fruit after 3 days, because it can get really fizzy and just explode over the top. And if you leave, once you've taken the fruit out and you leave it on your shelves in the glass jars are better with a good seal. I suggest that you put it in the fridge for a day before opening it, because it will explode everywhere from fermenting much, much longer. So just experiment with whatever you like, whatever flavours you like. And for more videos, like and subscribe.